7th lecture of TS classes. In this lecture, we will study about the signal flow graph. As we have discussed in the previous class that block diagram reduction technique. In block diagram reduction technique, there were some specific terms, that is block, summing point and take-up point. So also in this signal flow graph, we will study about some basic terms that we will discuss one by one later. First, we know what is a signal flow graph. We have studied that the block diagram reduction technique, the block diagram is a pictorial representation of control system. So in signal flow graph is a graphical representation of control system. Okay, this is the example of a signal flow graph. This is a graphical representation of control system. Some terms related to this graph is given here. We will discuss it one by one. First, we will go for the node. What is a node? Node is a point. Node is a point. In this graph, we have 6 nodes. X1, X2, X3, X4, X5 and X6. 6 nodes are here. Okay? Next, branch. What is a branch? Branch is a point. Branch is the combination of 2 points. That means X1 and X2 are 2 nodes. And by connecting 2 nodes, a line is connected. This line is known as a branch. Similarly, from X2 to X3, one line is connected, that is also a branch. Similarly, from X3 to X2, another line is connected. This is also a branch. So, from one node to another node, the line which is connected is known as a branch. Then we go for a transmittance. What is transmittance? Transmittance is the gain. Transmittance is the gain. That means from X1 to X2, in a branch, the value which is transmitted, that is A12, is the gain part. From X1, A12 is transmitted to X2. That means in the branch, this branch, A12 is transmitted from X1 to X2. Similarly, we go for X3 to X4. From X3 to X4, there is a branch. The branch is, in this branch, the gain will be XA34. Similarly, from X1 to X6, there are several nodes as well as several branch and several transmittances present. Then we will go for the input node. What is the input node? Input node means in the graphical representation, the point from which only the signal is outgoing. No incoming point is there. No incoming signal is there. It means from X1 to X2, there is the only one node, that is the X1 node, from which the signal is outgoing. No incoming signal in X1. So X1 is only the input node. But then next we go for the output node. What is the output node? Output node means the node to which only the incoming signal is present. No outgoing signal is here. Okay? At X6, A56 is the branch transmittance from X5 to X6. Okay? That means X6 is the output node. Next, we go for mixed node. What is a mixed node? Mixed node means the node to which some input signal is present as well as some output signal is going through. That means if you go for the point here, X4 point, here the input signal is coming, that is A34. The output here is going out, that is A45. Also, some output is given here is A42. So, this is A43. So, X4 is a mixed point. Similarly, with excluding X1 and X6, X1, X3, X4 and X5, all these are mixed node. Forward path, that means it is a path in which the signal is passing from the input node and ending at the output node. But within this, no node is traversed more than once. That means from input node X1, the signal is started and terminated at X6. But in this line, no node is traversed more than once. Here, we have the forward path. There is two forward paths. That is, started from X1, then X2, X3, X4, X5 and X6. This line, a straight line, is a fast forward path P1. Similarly, we have another forward path is here. That is, X1, started from X1, then X2, then X3, then in this direction, X5, then X6. This is another forward path. We have two forward paths here. That is P1 and P2. P1 is a straight line and P2 is the allow in this direction. Okay, this is the forward path. Loop. Loop means it is a path in which the input and output node is same. That means the signal which is started and which is ended, both are at the same point. But in this path, no other node is encountered more than once. Here we have the example. If the signal is starting from the point x2, it is going to the signal going to the point x3, then it is reversed back to x2. That means within this movement, x3 is encountered, but only for once, not more than once it is encountered, and the starting point and ending point is x2. Similarly, if the signal is starting from x3, it is going through x4 and again back to x3. That means x3 x4 x3, it is also another loop. Similarly, another loop is x4 x4. This is a loop. Next, self loop. We have already discussed that is the point from the in the point x4. A loop, here is a loop, but in this loop no other point is here. That means the signal is started at x4 and ended at x4. Within this movement no other node is present. That means if the signal is starting at x4 and it moves only here and end also at x4, so it is a self loop. Then we will go for non-touching loop. Non-touching loop means we have in the graph several loops. Within those loops, two loops which having no common nodes. That means if in this loop, this is a loop and this is another loop, within these two loops no common node is present, so these two loops are two non-touching loops. Okay, clear? Next we go for forward path again. We have already discussed what is a forward path. Forward path from x1 to x6. Okay, and no node is present more than once. Within this traversal, if the product of the transmittance, we have studied two forward path, path 1 and path 2. Path 1 was started from x1 in the straight line till x6. Path 2 was started from x1, x2, x3 and then in this direction x5 and x6. Here what is the forward path gain? Forward path gain means it is the product of the transmittance. Okay, so in P1 the gain will be A12 into A23 into A34 into A45 into A56. This is the product of the fast loop, fast forward path gain. Then what is P2? The forward path gain in other direction. P2 will be A12 into A23 into A35 into A56. Two forward path is present in this graph. So these two are the two forward path, gain 1 and gain 2. Next, loop gain. Loop gain, we have already studied what is a loop. Here we have studied three loops is present. Loop 1, the gain for the loop 1 is the product of the branch transmittance. That means loop 1 was started from x2 till x3, again back to x2. So here loop gain is equal to a23 into minus of a32. Okay, loop 1. Then for the loop 2, the gain is equal to loop 2 was here from starting from x3 till x4, again back to x3. So L2 is equal to, the gain of the L2 is equal to A34 into minus of A43. Similarly, we have another loop, that is the self loop which is present in the A4, X4. So, L3 is equal to, loop 3 gain is equal to A44. These are the three loop gains. In the today's class, we have studied about the signal flow graph and all the terms related to signal flow graph. Okay, thank you.